everyone. Welcome to our Friday 15. Tonight we are going to be really opening up through the hips. And as far as props, you're going to want a long pillow. If you have a normal yoga practice, regular, I should say, not normal, and you have a bolster, you can grab one of those, or you can roll up a blanket or use a pillow off of your bed. You might also want a block or a water bottle you can use. If you want to pause this video, get some water, feel free, maybe a blanket for our rest at the end, go ahead and do that. And otherwise, we're going to go ahead and get started. So starting with our seated cat-cows, palms on knees. Inhale, chest comes forward, chin comes up. Exhale, round the spine, chin to chest. Inhale, chest comes forward, chin up. Exhale, round the spine. Continuing on, just like that. I'm just going to turn. So if anyone is wondering if they're doing it right, what it should look like, you'll have some sort of visual. I haven't shown you this in videos before. So do two more. Inhale, lift up through the chest, gaze to ceiling. Exhale, round the spine, elbows flare, chin to chest. Inhale, forward. Exhale, round the spine. And coming back up to seated. Coming over onto hands and knees, you're gonna step the right leg forward. We're coming into a low lunge. I guess you can't see me in the frame there. So right knee stacked right above the right ankle. Left leg walks back. Lunging nice and low here. You can have the toes tucked or you can release the top of the foot onto the floor, which is what I would recommend. Lunging nice and low. You have the option to put your hands on your knee. I'll stay down here, mostly just so I'm in the frame. Breathing in through the nose, out through the nose. Long spine. See if you can draw back through the right hip a bit. So we're really stretching out the front of the left hip. Inhale, lift the chest. Exhale, sink a little lower into the lunge. Last breath here. You're gonna walk the right foot out towards the edge of your mat. Hands come inside, maybe even walk that right foot out a little bit further and allow the knee to fall open a bit. I don't know if you can see that on camera. So I'm rocking onto the outside of my foot here. Both hands, chin can hang heavy. And just imagine that the outside of your knee has a little gentle magnet, kind of drawing it down towards the floor. So there's nothing active here. You're just letting that leg be heavy, rocking onto the outside of the right foot, if that's accessible to you. And breathing into the hips. So really breathing into the front of the left hip, thinking long spine. Lifting your chest. A few more breaths here. Breathing into the belly, breathing into the hips. Next breath. Rock the sole of the right foot back down onto the floor. Heel toe it in. And then walk the hands back, stretching out through the right leg. Maybe staying here. Maybe folding over that leg. So three breaths. Inhale, long spine. Exhale, rounding forward. Inhale, long spine. Keeping that right foot flexed. Exhale, rounding over. Last breath, inhale, stretch. Exhale, fold. Coming back up. Hands come in front of you. Press yourself up to a wide-legged fold. I'm sorry that the lighting is a little bit dark. I'm filming at night here. So maybe you'll have your legs not quite as wide as me. Maybe this feels good. Maybe you can get all the way down onto the floor in your fold. Find what works for you. Feel free to keep a generous bend in the knees here. And then together, we're just going to sort of rock side to side, working into the ankles, into the hamstrings. Inhale, weight into the right foot, inside of the left foot. And shifting your weight inside of the right foot, outside of the left foot. Might just take a little bit of practice, see how it feels. Maybe switch directions if you're figure eighting. Does it feel good? You can just stay in the fold. Inhale, long spine. Walk your hands over towards the left foot. Coming down into your low lunge. So left knee right above left ankle. Top of the right foot releases to the mat. Option to have your hands on your knee and lift up through your chest. For purposes of staying in the frame, I'm going to keep my fingers tented. All the same, inhale, think about lifting the chest, long spine, draw the left hip back, breathing into the front of the right hip crease, filling the belly wherever you are. Inhale, imagine you're filling your whole body up like a balloon. Exhale, release. Squeeze the belly button towards the spine, empty the lungs. Two more breaths here. That's one, sink a little lower. And two, both hands come on the inside of that foot. Left foot walks to the outside edge of your mat, maybe further. And then allow the left knee to fall towards the floor, rocking onto the left edge, outside edge of the foot. Inhale, long spine. Exhale, gently, chin to chest, head hangs heavy. Five breaths here. I was taught this as lizard pose. That might actually be wrong, but for tonight we'll call it lizard pose. Three more breaths all together. Spread those fingers wide. While we're here, imagine that the heel of your hand and the tips of your fingers are kind of gently tugging towards each other here. See if that changes the way you're holding yourself. One more big breath. Exhale, bring the sole of the left foot to the mat, heel toe it back in, drawing back through the hips, straightening the left leg, flex the foot. Inhale for length, exhale for fold. Inhale for length, exhale to fold. Inhale for length, maybe you're all the way up here, that's totally fine. Exhale, fold. Just a couple more breaths wherever you are. Back into your lunge, hands come around to the front, back into wide-legged forward fold. Pigeon toes, your big toes in, just about an inch. Inhale for length, bend in the knees, exhale to fold. Maybe again you're standing more upright, maybe you want to hold on to your elbows here or the back of your head. Keeping a bend in the knees, press the big toes into the mat. See if you can bring your weight forward just a tiny bit more. Lengthening through the backs of the legs. The more you ground down through your big toe and the front of your foot, and you think about pulling your feet apart, the more you can combat that fear of falling on your face that we all have. Hands come to the floor. Heel toe the feet in towards one another. And coming down to seated. We're going to make our way onto our backs for thread the needle pose. Soles of the feet on the mat. Inhale, right heel up towards the ceiling. Maybe point the toe here. Flex the foot. Point the toe. Flex the foot. Point the toe, flex the foot, keeping the foot flexed. Bring the outside of the right ankle to the top of the left knee. Now you might stay here. This might be enough for you, and that's totally fine. Thinking about keeping the left leg soft and the right knee bent. If you have any furry companions, younger visitors, just let them do their thing. Focus on trying to find a little bit of calm in the chaos, a little bit of stillness in the middle of distraction. If you'd like to add on, you can interlace your fingers either behind the thigh, or if you have a lot of mobility, you can interlace your fingers in front of your shin. This is really intense for you. I know it is for me. That's not what we're going for. I'm just going for a gentle opening. Left leg is soft. Right foot is flexed to protect the knee joint. Try and keep the lower back and both shoulders flat on the floor here. Two more breaths. Last breath. Release the left foot to the floor, right foot to the floor. Hug both knees in towards your chest. And right foot to the floor, left foot straight up to the ceiling. Point the toes and flex the foot. Point the toes, flex the foot, point the toes. I've been taking dance classes with one of my best friends online. I've been pointing my toes a lot today. Flex the foot and then taking the outside of the left ankle to the top of the right knee. Possibly staying here for thread the needle or interlacing the hands behind the right thigh. Right leg is soft. Be patient with yourself. Know that both sides are rarely symmetrical, if ever, in anyone's body. Using the breath as a tool to see what you need. If you need a little more, a little less. Hanging out here. Breathing together. They're waking up for the day ahead or winding down from the day you've just had, depending on when you're watching. A few more breaths. Slow and full. Last one. Release the hands, release the sole of the foot to the floor, and left foot comes to the floor. Find your bolster or your pillow, maybe a blanket. You're going to slide that behind your knees, and then coming back down onto the back, extend the legs out. Legs about mat width apart, arms out to the side, palms facing up. Setting aside 2 minutes. For Shavasana, I often don't include it in our short videos, but today I feel like it's important to take this time. I will hold the space for you. I'll let you know when we're done. Anytime you find yourself focusing on noises or movements happening around you, draw yourself back to your body by focusing on your breath. In through the nose, out through the nose. Softness. finding stillness. Take a moment to appreciate your body for everything it does for you. Keeping you breathing, for pumping your blood, all the things it does without you having to ask it to. Maybe take a moment to think about other ways that you show up for yourself. Possibly ways that you're not showing up for yourself right now, but that you could. In a moment, beginning to draw our awareness back, wiggling your fingers, wiggling your toes. Maybe reaching your arms up overhead, draw the heels together for a full body stretch. And rolling on to one side, knees up towards your chest, fetal position. When you're ready, pressing up to seated. Maybe taking a little twist to each side. And closing class together with one final breath. Inhale, arms sweep up. Exhale, hands to heart center. Namaste. Thank you for practicing with me. I have videos going out every Monday, Wednesday, and Friday. Chair yoga, Friday 15 for lower back. Wednesdays is a bit of a rotation and occasionally guided meditations, as well as kids yoga with Cinderella every Friday on the Royal Headquarters Facebook page.